How you doing? It's Drew from Blackstar Amps down with Nevada Music. Today we're going to talk about our new ID amplifier. Here we have the ID60, which is part of the new Blackstar ID range, which is going to be hitting the shops very soon. This is Blackstar's first ever product that doesn't contain valves. Don't let that put you off, because we've got some very clever technology in here that, it makes you think that there are valves in it, even though there aren't. It's a digital programmable amp that covers lots of different sort of tones. I'll go a bit more in depth on how that works. You've got various effects, you've got programmability, you can connect it up to your PC for recording, you've got the ability to reamp, you've got a headphone socket. It's kind of, it does everything you need an amp to do. It will work very well at volume. Traditionally, digital amps, when you turn them up, don't work too well in a band environment. This is different. This works extremely well in that environment. It's very loud, projects its sound very well. So let's give you some tones. Right, so I just want to run you through some of the functions of the amp. Basically, you've got a voice selector. This is where you can choose your voicing type. So anything from bright clean, warm clean, crunch, super crunch, OD1, OD2. We then have a gain and preamp volume. We have EQ and our patented ISF technology, which allows you to get the different voicings. And then the clever bit is the TVP, true valve power. And this basically emulates all the different power valve types. So you've got six different valve types in there: EL84, 6V6, EL34, KT66, 6L6, and KT88. And these basically emulate those power valve types. So lots of different amps over the years have used different power valves in them, and they all give you a different sort of tonal characteristics. So what we wanted to do is allow you to, with your preset voicing and your ISF and your TVP, basically jump in there and find some really cool tones. So I'm just going to run through some of those as well, starting with a warm clean. So let's give you a nice warm clean. So I'm using warm clean, I've got the gain backed off, got the ISF cranked over to the American side, and I'm running through a 6L6, and it sounds like this. So you get a really nice, big, fat, clean sound. So next up, I'm going to switch this over to a bright clean. I'm going to go to an EL84. I'm going to crank the gain up, and this is going to give us a really natural sort of breakup, crunchy breakup. I'm going to move that round to the TVP round to a 6V6 now. So 6V6 traditionally are found in small F-type amps. So this gives you a bit more compression and a slightly earlier breakup. So I'm just going to back off the gain a bit, sticking with bright clean. We'll be right back. Now I'm moving through to a slightly more traditional sort of British crunch. So I'm going on a crunch tone with an EL34, gain cranked a bit more. Right, so now I'm sticking with the EL34s, moving on to a super crunch, so this is sort of a modded British crunch sound. Now I'm going to stick it on 6L6, OD1, crank the gain a bit more, stick the ISF on the American side, scoop the mids. This is going to give us a really big, fat, sort of chuggy sort of drive. Next up, I've got OD2 going into a set of KT88s. This is kind of like our Blackstar Series 1 200 watt head. So. So there we go, that covers some of the basic tones you can get in there. I mean, that's just sort of scratching the surface. That's just some of the core tones I wanted to show you. But once you sort of get one at home and you start fiddling with all these controls here, there's just so many different parameters and so many different tones you can get in there. So I was using the amp in manual mode there, and manual mode, it just works like any other amp. It's what you see is what you get. And then you've also got preset mode as well. So any of the controls, apart from the resonance, present, and master at the end, are all programmable. So if you find a really nice sound you want, simply press and hold where you want to store it, press the button again, and you've now stored your patch. So it's as simple as that to save your patches. There is an additional foot switch that's available for it as well. This allows you to access 128 patches without the foot switch. You've got 12 patches, basically three banks of four, and it also allows you to use it in a pedal board mode, because there are some inbuilt effects as well. We've got four types of reverb, four types of delay, four types of modulation, and it allows you, when you're in pedal board mode, to use it like you would use a set of pedals. So you can turn your reverb on and off, you can turn your delay on and off, you turn your modulation on and off. You've got a global tap tempo, and another cool little feature on the pedal is you can preset the tap tempo speed of your delay and your modulation before you turn it on. So in a gig scenario, if you've got a drummer that likes to speed up and speed down, you can make sure that your effects are running at the right tempo, which is really useful. Okay, I'm just going to show you some of the effects now. So first option there is reverb. So just to give you a very brief soundbite of each one. In the first position, we have a room reverb. Next position, we have a hall reverb, which is a nice big one. Mm-hmm. Moving on to spring. And finally, we have a plate reverb in there as well. Next up, we got the delay section. The first of which is a linear delay, which sounds like this. And then you also have tap tempo to control that as well, so if you want a shorter one. Next up, we've got analog delay, and that sounds a bit like this. Next up is our tape delay. And finally, we've got a multi-delay. Next up is modulation. We have four different types of effect, the first one being a phaser. Then moving around to flanger. We then have chorus, which sounds like this. And finally, we got tremolo. I'll just show the tap tempo, we can slow that down. And finally, we can have all three of those on at the same time. So this is all three of them. Okay, that covers most of the tones in the amp. Just to show you some of the other features on there. This amp has got two emulated outs. There's one on the back which doubles as a stereo headphone socket. And the stereo effects sound really good through that. So that you can use to go straight to a desk. The second emulated out is a USB. Now this can be used for a number of functions. One is to link to your PC with a graphic user interface which you can download once you purchase the amp. This allows you some deeper editing facilities, allows you to save patches. There's an audio playback function with a phrase trainer in there, there's a tuner, and there's also an online community where you can download artist presets, share patches, that sort of stuff. But the clever bit about the USB is you can send more than one signal of audio. So if you're recording, this means that it sends two signals out, a wet signal with your affected sound and a dry signal. And with the dry signal, if you nail your part and you're not quite happy with the sound, you can send it back through the amp and choose a new tone. And you can do that as many times as you want. So as a recording tool, it's really, really good. On the back, as well as the emulated out, we've also got a line input, so you can plug your iPod or other generic MP3 player in the back and jam along to it. There's also MIDI switching as well. If you use any kind of MIDI board, you can connect this to the amp and switch your effects and the amp simultaneously. And there's also the foot switch connector. This is a foot switch. It's an addition. They're just under £50, and this gives you full functionality of the amp. It means you can use it in pedalboard mode, where you can turn on and off your three effects and tap tempo. You can use it in preset mode, where you can access up to 128 presets, But they come with 12 set, and then it's kind of up to you to create your own. And there's also a store mode, so if you've got a really great sound, you can store that from the foot switch as well. So if you're looking for an affordable amp that's got lots of functions, lots of great tones, one that's going to work live, one that's going to work for recording, one that's going to work for practice, Blackstar ID amps are sort of ideally placed for that. Very reasonably priced. This one is the ID60 1x12 combo, which is £399. They will also be in early 2013, sort of January time, a 15 watt combo at £199, a 30 watt combo at £279, and then arriving just before Christmas, we have this model, the ID60. There is also an ID260, which is a 2x12 stereo combo. There's a 60 watt head, and there's also a 100 watt head as well. I mean, it's between £199 and £459. It's all very reasonably priced, and they're great sounding amps, so come down and check them out. Thank you.